Okay. All right. I'd like to welcome you to the NCCC Compliance Project that is funded by a SUNY IITG grant. And this is the last of our 30-minute Mentor Mondays. And I hope these presentations have helped you with your compliance updates. Please take a look at our YouTube channel for all the compliance videos. Just search for NCCC or compliance to see those. Okay. All right. One of the things I'd like to point out is, why do you need to convert anything to a PDF? And a couple of things that the reasons behind this is, one, that a PDF file, just about everybody can print out and view a PDF file on their computer, on their laptop, whether it's Mac or PC. So it gives everybody the option without having to download any special software. They don't have to purchase anything. And if you give a student a Word document, if they don't have Microsoft Word, they might not be able to open it. They might not be able to print it out. So it's highly recommended that any documents that we provide, especially if we want our students to print, that we provide them a PDF file format. Okay, so that's why we're, you know, talking about converting to PDF. Okay, and the other thing is, the Adobe Readers, even if you have a student that doesn't have a disability and they just want to have the documents read to them, if they open up a PDF, they can actually go in and use the Adobe Reader to have it read to them. So it's a good idea to set this up. And most screen readers can read a PDF if it's been done properly. Okay, so that's another reason why you want a PDF. Okay, and what do you need to make an accessible PDF? Basically, anything that you've built as an accessible Word file, an Excel spreadsheet, or a PowerPoint presentation, if it's gone through the accessibility checker, it will be an accessible PDF when you download it, if you do it the right way. The big thing, and you might want to refer back to some of our old videos on how to make objects compliant and how to make Word documents compliant to help you out with some of the stuff. But some of the key things you want to be concerned with is making sure that alt text is on any images, tables, or charts. And if you're building like a Word document or any kind of word processing document, your headings should be labeled as headings and not just making them in like a different color font or a different font size or making them bold. So you should actually label them as heading, heading one, heading two, and so on. Hyperlinks, make sure that your hyperlinks are active. If they are not active in the PDF so that a student can click on a hyperlink, it's not going to be accessible for everybody. Okay, and if you do have hyperlinks, you want to make sure that you either show the text or you convert it to a tiny URL to make it easier for them to, if they had to type it in for any reason, they at least had something to grab. And they could copy and paste it, they could click on it, or they could type in the URL if they needed to. Okay, especially if you make it a tiny URL. Okay, so those are the main things you want to be concerned with if you're going to take any kind of document and convert it into a PDF. Okay, now I have it up here that you're saving a Word file as a PDF. This is the same steps that you would take to save any Microsoft Office file and save it as a PDF. What you're going to do is go into File and Save As, and underneath the Save As type, you're going to change it to a PDF. And then what you want to do is click on Options. And in this diagram, you can see here that I have the Options button. I'm pointing to it with a red arrow. So when you go into the Options button, you have an option that says Document Structure Tags for Accessibility. And you want to make sure that this is checked. If this is not checked, then it doesn't take like the heading one, the heading two, and apply that to the document when it converts it to a PDF. It also, if you have bookmarks throughout the document, like an active table of contents, or if you have hyperlinks that you have as active links. If this is not on when it converts it to a PDF, it might not take that information and set up the tags properly in that document. So it's very important to make sure that this is checked. And I think the default is for this to be checked, so it shouldn't be an issue if you forgot to do it in previous documents that you've set up. The one thing that you don't want to do, and this is an option in a lot of programs, where you can do a print to PDF. The print to PDF does not grab those tags and pull them in, and you don't have this tag as an option in the print to PDF option in any of your Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or any of the other documents that you might have created. So it's very important to make sure that you do a file save as and not a print to PDF to create these files. Okay, so that's, I mean, it's pretty easy to go in and create an accessible Word document, accessible PowerPoint, and save them as a PDF. Okay, now another PDF that we often have are scanned in pages. And a lot of our older scanners did not have the ability to scan the text in, if you had a hard copy of a document, and convert that text to actually typed in text. A lot of the older scanners would actually grab it as an image and throw a picture into a PDF file. And the problem with that is that a document could not be read through a screen reader if you had set this up. So a couple of things to look for if you scan in an actual text document, make sure the scanner has the ability to convert it to text. And if you have some old scanned in documents, check those documents. And I'm going to show you an example on how to do this. And make sure that it can actually be read out loud. If it's an actual image on the page, it will give you a message that either the page is blank or it will say that it's an unreadable picture on the page. So it's very important to make sure that you use a scanner that's capable of doing this. Okay. And for our NCCC faculty, in FRACI, they have a special scanner that will take a text document and convert it into an accessible PDF. So if you have any of those documents, that maybe you've done in the past and you only have in a hard copy format, you could take them to FRACI and do those through the scanner in there, and then it will become an accessible PDF. Okay, so that's one resource that you can use. Now, if you have a handwritten page that maybe you have equations, I've seen it in the math department, I've seen it in the nursing department. And if you have something like that, you would actually have to type it in and have it something that can be read through the PDF, through the Adobe Reader. So it's important to make sure that you don't take handwritten documents and scan those in and include those in your courses because they're not accessible. Okay, so just, you know, make sure that you can read them. Okay, now, if you do have a PDF that you've scanned in and you want to check, you want to go and bring them up in Adobe. And in Adobe, you want to go through View and Read Out Loud, and that turns on the feature. If you select text, it should automatically read that text out loud. Or if you go back into View and Read Out Loud, you can pick the option to read just the page that you're on or read to the end of the document. So at that point, that's where you will get that message that if it's just an image, that it won't be able to read that page, okay, out loud to the, and it's going to be the same thing if you go into any screen readers, whether it be the Adobe Reader or one of like Dragon or one of the other screen readers. So it's got to be an accessible PDF for it to work properly. Okay. Like I said, I'm going to show you an example so you can see what it looks like. Okay. So those are the main things of creating a PDF. If you have a Word document, an Excel spreadsheet, or a PowerPoint, I would recommend go through the accessibility checker in those documents and set them up properly and then save them as a PDF so that you know that they're in the right format so that they'll be able to be read by the screen readers. Okay. Now, we still have our resources, and I know that the Buffalo State page has a one-hour video that you can go in, and it talks about making a PDF accessible. So I would take a look at that. I would highly recommend that. The FACT2 accessibility website also has documentation and videos in there. And then we offer pretty much everything that we have on this list through our NCCC eLearning Faculty Resource Center. So it's a good idea to go in and take a look at some of those pages. Okay. I'm going to switch over to a document real quick just to show you. Let me see here. Okay. I am not showing a page that I need to show you. So let me go back to this again. But when you go into the Adobe Reader, just make sure you tell it to read out loud and make sure it can read it to you. If it can't read it to you, then it can't. It's not an accessible content. Okay. All right. So at this point, Lynn, do you have anything that you can add or?
No, that was great, Dawn.
Okay. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording. What is it doing here? Hold on. I'm not having luck today.